Hi, my name is Jesus Cabrera from Solution Support Security Team. In this video, I want to give you an introduction on how to use REST API for Cisco Secure Firewall devices, previously known as Firepower. We will review how to enable and perform basic operations using Firewall Management Center API Explorer. REST API is an application programming interface that can communicate based off RESTful principles. REST APIs communicate via HTTP requests to perform CRUD operations within a resource. Configuration through REST API enables a great deal of possibilities to automate and streamline the way you configure secure firewall devices. Main advantages of using REST API are scalability, since operations can be extended to several resources. Flexibility, easy to implement on different software development environments. As most APIs, it works with XML, JSON, and HTTP. Automation, you can streamline configuration processes for several devices at a time by performing configuration changes in bulk and reduce time-consuming, repetitive configuration tasks. REST API relies on the same authentication as FMC and FDM, and uses OAuth 2.0. Each function in the REST API maps to the same permissions in FMC and FDM. REST API is enabled by default in FMC. You can confirm it's enabled by navigating to System, Configuration, REST API Preferences, and make sure REST API is enabled. FMC and FDM have a built-in interface called API Explorer. This is a helpful tool to review the capabilities and functions of REST API. For FMC, API Explorer can be accessed with the following URL by adding /api/api-explorer to the FMC URL IP or FQDN. Once accessing the API Explorer, we will be taken to the homepage, where we will find the top ribbon, domains, and configuration sections. In the top right corner, we can find the version information as well as helpful resources. Next, we will find all the configuration sections, starting with the domains. Selecting this dropdown will display all existing FMC domains. Right below domains, we will see all the configuration sections and capabilities, including features that are supported by FMC. Now, going back to the configuration sections, we will see that REST API for FMC supports the following HTTP methods. Note that each one of them performs a CRUD operation. GET corresponds to read, POST to create, PUT to update or replace, and delete. The URI, Unified Resource Identifier, will accompany each of these methods with the corresponding path to each object. By selecting one of these methods, we can expand and see the parameters included in our HTTP requests. Filter, offset, limit, expanded, and the domain UUID. Please keep in mind that the domain UUID is crucial when generating the HTTP requests, since each object will have a unique identifier assigned, and such is required to perform operations. Now we're ready to test API Explorer functionality by clicking on Try It Out. For this particular HTTP GET request of devices and device records, we're not required to include any other UUID or parameter, and we can simply execute. Following up next, we will see the response section, where we will find the curl and request URL along with the default server response to this method, and some server response examples. FMC will provide a server response of 200 if the HTTP request was successful, and response body will contain the device information for all registered devices in our FMC. For this output, we can see that I have one FTD managed by this FMC, named FTDV703. We can write down the ID value as it is used to access the API requests targeted to this FTD in particular. As a final example, we can retrieve all the interface configuration of a particular managed device, or FTD, by using the UID of a device obtained from the previous response in the following method. We go to get devices, device records, physical interfaces. FMC replies with the server response output. And we can see that this device has two data interfaces and a diagnostic interface configured with their corresponding UUID and configurations. The previous tree-like structure and logic of accessing the HTTP methods is applicable to all objects. Going from general to specific UUID, we can read, modify, or add configuration changes to FMC and specific managed devices. Note that the API Explorer can be of great use as a guide, allowing you to view the supported features and configuration methods so you can design and customize your code for configuration deployments. You can visit the Secure Firewall Repository in GitHub to view a great deal of templates and automation resources at github.com/ciscodevnet/securefirewall. I invite you to step into the world of automation, discover and test configuration using REST API for Cisco Secure Firewall.